The following footage was recorded on the 19th of March, 2014. It was recorded immediately after the proceedings in New York State Supreme Court relative to the election in Bloomingburg, New York. This footage contains comments and perspectives of attorneys representing various parties involved in the case. We are airing this footage with the intention of bringing our viewers up to speed in regard to this case prior to the March 31st, 2014 continuance. We hope you find this informative and useful.
I have been asked to represent the candidates for the Rural Heritage Party in connection with this election and in the matter of the challenge registrations of a number of voters that have appeared after February 2nd and before the cutoff date to register to vote in this election.
Okay, the consensus seems to be that, as I see it, you can correct me if I'm wrong, because I don't speak legal speak, but it seems that the consensus right now is in an abundance of caution. That the scheduling perhaps is a little bit ahead of the process, and for the time being it's been adjourned to let the Board of Elections complete their investigations regarding the challenges.
The attorneys for the respondents contend that it would be inappropriate for this court to proceed with the taking of evidence before the Board of Elections completes its administrative investigation of the challenge voters.
Okay.
So enough time was allowed for the Board of Elections, a 10-day interval was allowed for the Board of Elections to do that work, and counsel for the Board of Elections, Mr. Cawley, indicated that he believed, after consultation with the Board of Elections, his clients, that that was sufficient time to do that.
And that time hasn't lapsed as of yet, which
that's the time between now and March 31st.
Oh, okay. So that time is given in this time frame. And the other question is when we were spoken with the attorney for the, in this case, I'm just going to say opposing side because I'll get the legal word wrong. He stated that he was intending to make a motion for dismissal because of the way that the subpoenas for this were put forth.
Every attorney has a duty to do everything that is allowable within the law or any arguable interpretation of the law on behalf of his client, his or her client. And so there are two challenges, or basic challenges, attacks, if you will, that of which we're aware. One is to the petition generally. The argument is made that because it challenges the rights of voters, they have due process rights to be made parties to it, and since they weren't made parties, that the petition is therefore defective. Our position is that the challenge wasn't to the credentials of voters, especially the voters who didn't vote. There are 140, almost 150 challenges to pending, but only in the aggregate, well, actually 150 challenges to newly registered voters and another 83 or 80 odd that were filed by the other side for a total of about 230 outstanding challenges. Only 125 or so of those voters presented themselves yesterday to vote. So our contention is we're only concerned with the people who voted. We're only concerned with the propriety of the election. We have no abstract interest in voters who didn't come to vote yesterday.
Or perhaps voters who didn't register somewhere else and were thus not represented as removed from the rolls.
Well, of course, that's part of the investigatory process. Right. So we don't, if there's some voter that had they voted we would be interested in but didn't vote, that's passed now. We have no longer, why would that voter need to be a party to this litigation since they didn't vote yesterday? We're only concerned with having a fair election. That's the only interest that we have. We want everybody who's entitled to vote as a resident of the village of Bloomingburg to, we want their votes to count. Everybody. But if people were suddenly appeared and said they're residents, but they really weren't, those voters, that's in effect a way of, you could say, rigging an election, and we object to that.
Okay, now, it's very, I'm guessing the math will bear it out. I'm just not going to do it in my head right now. But the math that I'm asking about is math regard to the 107 that voted. Are those 107 that voted, that were questioned, were specifically in front of, they're what's coming in front of the court today because those are the people who received the subpoenas.
Okay,
from your client.
I'm not sure exactly which side you're referring to. Of the voters whose votes were canvassed yesterday, with regard to whom there were no objections, it was about 81-25, as I understand it. So that's 106 or so votes that got counted. And then the preliminary count is 81-25.
81-25, 80-25, 79, and
exactly. 84. That ballpark, right? So as to the other 125 or so, all of those, well, many of those witnesses, we haven't correlated which ones were our side's previous challenge and which ones were the respondent's previous challenge.
Okay, so we don't know who voted and who had a subpoena filed. That was my question.
There are dueling challenges here, right? Each side, you know, our side challenged, the other side responded with its set of challenges. Now, the subpoenas that were issued before today were only from our side. So they want to quash those subpoenas, and this is kind of amusing to me because we attempted personal service on Sunday out of respect for the Sabbath that universally the voters that we're challenging, at least as we understand it, observe the Sabbath of Saturday. So we did not attempt to try to find them physically on their Sabbath day. We did on Sunday. However, there's the statutory Sabbath, which is Sunday. It applies it arguably applies by statute to everybody, and therefore they objected to the service on Sunday. Not their client's Sabbath, but, oh, who cares? So if we had served them on Saturday, imagine the objection that would have been made. In fact, when the judge issued the order to show cause last week, he directed us not to serve it on the respondents on Saturday out of respect for their Sabbath. So he asked us to make sure it was deliverable on Monday to those respondents. So we may have to, if we can't reach an agreement with counsel on these subpoenas, reserve them. If we have to, we will.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you, Jonathan. Nice to meet you.